Imagine yourself living in a mental asylum, even when you're mentally healthy. Nobody there believes that you're sane, and you're put on a number of medications. You feel helpless, frustrated, and completely stuck. This scenario feels like straight out of a horror or a thriller movie, but it can actually happen to you. In fact, it was very well proven in a study called Rosenhan experiment, which was cool, sad, scary, funny, and eye-opening at the same time. Hey everyone, this is TyroScience, simplified science to make you smarter. David Rosenhan was a professor at Stanford University. He conducted a study in which he selected 5 men and 3 women as pseudo patients or false patients who pretended to have auditory hallucinations to gain admissions in various psychiatric hospitals. They claimed to hear words like empty, hollow. These words vaguely suggest existential crisis or the time when people question if their life has any meaning. These words were chosen as there was lack of evidence to suggest that these are linked with psychotic behavior. All of them were admitted and were diagnosed with psychiatric disorders. Once admitted, all of them acted perfectly normal and told the staff that they felt fine, which, as in movies, they did not believe. 7 of them were diagnosed with schizophrenia, a mental disorder where a person can't properly understand reality and behave abnormally. And 1 was diagnosed with bipolar syndrome, a disorder that causes periods of depression and elevated moods. Once admitted, these pseudo patients were not able to get out until they accepted that they were mentally ill and agreed to take antipsychotic drugs that they flushed down. But I'm sure you guessed that part. Their average stay was 19 days and the maximum one was 52 days, during which they were subjected to dehumanizing behavior and invasion of privacy. Surprisingly, no staff member doubted that they were imposters, but a lot of fellow patients did. An offended hospital challenged Rosenhan to send patients to its facility and its staff can easily identify them. He agreed. In coming weeks, 250 patients were admitted to the hospital, out of which staff identified 41 as imposters. But here is the fun part. Rosenhan actually sent no patients to the hospital. This study clearly indicated that there was some problem identifying mental patients at that time. But a lot of experts also contradicted it, saying that psychiatry depends on how people report their symptoms, and fake reporting can alter diagnosis. This experiment started the process to reform mental institutions and discharge as many patients as possible. One of the main sites of this experiment, St. Elizabeth Hospital, is now boarded up and abandoned. A similar incident can do a great harm to a normal person and can cause permanent damage. This and several other experiments greatly improve the situation and reduce the chances of this happening to a normal person. Please hit the subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. Hit the notification bell. Don't forget to like, comment, and share. And as always, keep learning, keep exploring until you know everything.